children, welcome back to 5th standard English class. See children, in previous class we are started unit 6, pros for the dignity of labor. Yes, unit 6, pros for the dignity of labor. In previous class we are started. In this lesson we already studied or learned task A and task B, and also you are already completed in our textbook task A and task B. And also we have learned new words from this lesson, dignity of labor. Understand? And also we learned some paragraphs in this lesson. There was a businessman. Yes, no? There was a businessman. He had a lazy son. One day the businessman wanted to, his son became a hard worker and responsible person. So he decided to, I want to realize to my son value of hard work. So the businessman called him one day and said to him, today you go to outside and earn something. Otherwise, there is no food or dinner tonight. So the son is very afraid for his father order and not to use any kind of work himself. So he was very afraid and also very crying. After he went to his mother. When his mother saw the tears in her son, his heart was melted. And she gave a gold coin to his son. In the evening, his father came to the home and asked to the lazy boy, what you had earned? The boy showed a one gold coin to his father. The father told to him that coin threw into the well in front of our house. The boy, what his father told to him like that, he had did so. Understand? Next, he, the man, the businessman, has a wisdom. Has a wisdom man. So he guessed this gold coin given to him by her wife. So he decided to, he sent her, his wife, to her parents' house. Next day, the businessman told to his son to go outside and earn something. That time, the second time, his sister gave a rupee coin to the boy. Next evening, the businessman or his father asked to him what you had earned. That time, the boy showed a rupee coin to his father. That time also, the father told to boy or son that rupee also he have to throw into the well. The boy did as he told him. Next, after this, the father realized or guessed this time also anyone give to the help to the boy. And he sent her daughter, her in-laws house. Next day, the father sent his daughter her in-laws house. Understand? After calling his son and said to him, today you go to outside and earn something. This time there is no person help to the boy. So the son is go to outside search for work. Understand? Today we will continue the class dignity of labor. Okay? See. house. The boy accepted. The boy accepted the offer. He was sweating a lot by the time he finished the work. His feet were trembling and his neck and back were aching. He returned home and handed the 2 rupee coin to his father. His father asked him to throw it into the well. The boy cried out in pain and said, "Father, I earned this money. My entire body is aching. My palms have rashes and you are asking me to throw my all earned money into the well." The businessman was happy. His son had realized the value of hard work. The son promised never to be lazy. The father handed over the keys of his shop to the son. Once again, children, see, today we will start 6th paragraph. All of you observe your textbook, 6th paragraph, okay? This time there was no one to help the boy. He went to the market in search of work. A shopkeeper offered him 2 rupees for carrying his bag to his house. The boy accepted the offer. He was sweating a lot by the time he finished the work. His feet were trembling and his neck and back were aching. He returned home and handed the 2 rupee coin to his father. His father asked him to throw it into the well. The boy cried out in pain and said, "Father, I earned this money. My entire body is aching. My palms have rashes and you are asking me to throw my all earned money into the well." The businessman was happy. His son had realized the value of hard work. The son promised never to be lazy. The father handed over the keys of his shop to the son. Understand, children? See, now I give the explanation from 6th paragraph. Okay? In this time, there was no one to help the boy. First time, he get the help from his mother. Second time, he get the help from his sister. But third time, there is no one to help the lazy boy. Understand? He went to the market in search of work. There is no person to help the boy in that time. So he went to the search for work to the market. Understand? A shopkeeper offered him 2 rupees for carrying his bag to his house. In the market, a shopkeeper offered to the boy. Understand? Offer, give some offer to the boy. Who? A shopkeeper. What he told? A shopkeeper told to the boy for carrying his bag to his house. To carry his bag to his house. This work for I give to you 2 rupees. So the boy was accepted that a shopkeeper offer. Understand? So the boy accepted the offer. He was sweating a lot by the time he finished the work. When he was carrying the bag of shopkeeper to his house, that time the boy was sweating a lot by finishing that work. His feet were trembling. His feet were trembling. Trembling means what? Frightened. His feet. Feet, you already know that one. Feet it is neck and back. 1, 18. 8 means you already know that word. In the inverse, 8 means pain. Is neck and also is back bone was very pain. Understand? He returned home and handed the 2 rupee coin to his father. He finished his work and get the 2 rupee coin from a shopkeeper. never to be lazy. Understand? This is the message of dignity of labor lesson. Are you understand, children? So, in our life, we are all means you also, include me also. We are all do some work in our career or in our life. Never we are become to be lazy in our life. Understand? And also, we respect to all profession or occupation or work. Understand? You already know that one. What is the meaning of dignity of labor? Dignity means you already know that one. Respect. Labor means hard work. Dignity means what? Respect. Labor means what? Hard work. Understand, children, this lesson? Unit 6, prose, dignity of labor. Are you understand this lesson? Okay. Next, in previous class, we already learned in grammar part in gender. Isn't it? Yes. Now, you already know that one new word from this lesson. Next, we come to vocabulary. Understand? Write the CUL textbook. Write the other genders of the words. Underline it and complete the sentences. Write the other genders of the words. Underline it and complete the sentence. In your textbook, give some vocabulary exercises. Understand? You should complete that exercise in your textbook and also in your notebook also. See, write other genders of the words, underline it and complete the sentence. First sentence, see here. Vocabulary, you gave one exercise about the gender. Change the gender. Understand? First sentence, now we will see. Raju's father. Raju's father and Dash. Uncle and dash came we will change the gender. Uncle changing aunt. Understand? Uncle masculine gender, aunt feminine gender. Masculine gender change into feminine gender and complete the sentence. Understand? My uncle and aunt came to our house. Okay? Understand? Next, third sentence. My grandfather and dash go for a walk. Go for a walk. Here, underline the word grandfather. Understand? Now we will change the gender and complete the sentence. Okay? Grandfather change into feminine gender. Grandfather belongs to masculine gender. Now we will change the feminine gender. Here, what happened? Grandmother. Understand? My grandfather and grandmother go for a walk. Understand, children? Next sentence, fourth. Boys and dash play in the playground. Understand? See, boys and dash play in the playground. Boys change into feminine gender. Boys belongs to masculine gender. See, girls. Boys and girls play in the playground. Okay, next. Fifth one. The wife. The wife was cool and calm. Cool and calm. But Dash was tense. See, fifth sentence. The wife was cool and calm. Here, underline the word wife. Understand? The wife was cool and calm, but her husband. Her husband was pensive. Understand? Once again, the wife was cool and calm, but her husband was pensive. Understand? Wife is feminine gender. Understand? Wife is referred to feminine gender. Change into gender to masculine. Husband was pensive. Understand? All of you understand this vocabulary? Okay. Next. All of you write in your textbook. Understand? Second one. where first one A column, second one B column. Understand? You already learned dignity of labor lesson. Understand? This master following is belongs to this lesson. Understand? When you understand the lesson or understood the lesson, that then the master following is become very easy to reverse. Understand? Businessman. Second one, mother. Third one, sister. Fourth one, son. Fifth one, shopkeeper. Understand? Here, answer gave to rupees rich. Gold coin, 1 rupee, 1 rupee, and lazy. Understand? See here. See here. Match the following. This is also vocabulary exercise 2. Understand? Here 2 columns is there. A column and B column. We should match the answer. Understand? Choose the correct answer for column B. Sorry, column A. Understand? Column A for choose the correct answer from the column B. Understand? See here. Businessman. What is the answer? Search here. B column is what? Rich. Answer is businessman for answer is rich. And second one is mother. First day, mother gave to him what? Gold coin. Understand? Second answer, gold coin. Understand? Mother for correct answer, gold coin. And sister, the lazy boy, sister give the help in second day. She gave 1 rupee. Answer is 1 rupee. Understand? Son. What kind of son? Lazy. How was the son? Lazy boy. And shopkeeper. A shopkeeper give to the son. Mother, good girl. Sister, 1 rupee. Son, lazy. Shopkeeper, 2 rupee. Are you understand? Are you understand, children? Okay. You have to write down in your notes. Understand? Next. below. Understand? D. Refer. They refer to the father and the son in the lesson. Select the appropriate.
Understand? First one, scale. Scale means you already know that one.
lazy. Father lazy or son was lazy? Son. This word also related to or related to son. Next, wise. Who is wise? Father. Understand children? Understand this?